Hey everyone, this is MOSFET, your simple tech news update. Starting out with some robotics news, researchers at IMHC recently showed a couple new videos of their Nadia humanoid robot. In the first video, they demonstrated it doing a bit of boxing training, and I must admit, even though it's obviously not putting much power into its punches, the hooks look pretty smooth. This particular experiment showcased the Nadia's remote operation ability, where the bot was piloted by someone wearing a virtual reality headset and controllers. As we've seen from some of the other robots covered on the show, these kind of human-led demonstrations also will likely serve as training data for AI integrations, so expect this process to eventually become fully automated. The team also uploaded a different video a couple weeks ago too, this time showing off the bot's new walking capabilities. It's a little slow at the moment, but it's one of the first robots since Boston Dynamics Atlas that is pushing boundaries. In similar news, researchers at the University of Bremen released a preprint paper exploring how to make their own humanoid robot, the RH5, walk faster and more human-like. Again, much like the Nadia, this is still slow compared to us, but you can definitely see how these type of bots are improving. A team at the University of Tokyo have also been exploring alternatives to the common two- or four-legged robotic locomotion, opting to design a unique parallel wire-driven pogo leg for movement instead. Dubbed the Ramiel, this bouncy boy can jump up to 1.6 meters high and can pogo a maximum of 7 times consecutively. I've no idea what the potential applications are for this, but it is an interesting concept. In electronics news, and it's been a while since we last looked at the Airjet cooler by Frore Systems. PC World uploaded another video the other day showing how the system could be added to a MacBook Air to improve performance. For those who don't know, the Airjet coolers have no moving parts and use vibrating membranes to move air around at high speeds. This results in a super thin way to cool devices, and in the case of the MacBook Air, it allows the laptop to reach MacBook Pro levels of CPU performance because the same processor that's used in both machines is usually throttled in the air to stop overheating. Over in drone news, and Zipline passed another milestone in its bid to bring drone deliveries to the world. After receiving FAA approval earlier in the year, last week the company carried out its first beyond visual line of sight delivery in Salt Lake City, Utah. Apparently this is the first beyond visual line of sight real-world drone delivery in the US without any ground observers, carried out autonomously using the drone's onboard perception system. In other news, Tevel uploaded a new video of their fruit harvesting robot, which uses 8 autonomous drones to pick apples at an orchard in Italy. I briefly showed this at the beginning of the year, but this video goes into a bit more detail about how it all works. The farm owners claim there is a shortage of workers, and that this thing can work day and night, 24/7 picking apples with a single operator overseeing everything. Not only does it pick, but its system is also measuring, weighing, and sorting fruits automatically as it goes. More generative AI news this week, and Pika Labs launched version 1 of their text-to-video tool. The 6-month-old company says they've used a new AI model for this first official version of their app, and it's capable of generating and editing videos in a range of styles from 3D animation, anime, cartoon, cinematic, and more. In the blog post, the Pika team also announced they had just raised $55 million, and combined with the quality of the output, I think we'll probably be seeing more from them in the future. And ending this week with a couple more mixed reality stories. Firstly, aerospace provider BAE Systems announced Project Odyssey, which is an exploration into how forces might use virtual and augmented reality for training and operations management in the future. It's pretty standard stuff, like much of what we've seen over the last few years, but it underlines how these technologies are slowly working their way into many industries. Following on from that, this week Varjo announced their new next-generation mixed reality headset, the XR4. They claim it has the highest resolution of any XR headset, with 4K by 4K displays, 120 by 105 degree field of view, and something that they call the world's first gaze-driven autofocus system. In their launch trailer, they definitely position the device as a work tool, showing it being used by designers and by pilots for simulations. The XR4 starts at just under $4,000 and is available now. Alright, that's everything for this update. As always, source links are in the description. Subscribe to the channel for more cutting-edge news, or check out the MOSFET playlist. See you next time.